got a friend in me.
And he was out on the end of that arm, and they got a great picture of him out there, just standing on the end of the arm, going around the earth. You can imagine going from light to dark at night to day, out there inspecting all these piles. On that little platform just out there in space, well, that's one of the greatest pictures.
Should have seen it from my son.
Astronaut, but I, when I think of John, I don't think of astronaut, I think of all these other things that are associated with John. The greatest compliment I could give to John is that he and Annie are the people you want to live next door to.
You got a friend in me.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm Bob Cadena. I'm the director of the Kennedy Space Center. I had the privilege of flying Discovery twice. Back in 90 and 92, because you got a friend in me.
Yeah, you got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am,
bigger and stronger too,
baby,
but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy.
And as the years go by,
our friendship will never die.
You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me.
You got a friend in me.
Yeah, you got a friend in me.
Bags last night, pre-flight, 0 hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much. I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space on such a timeless flight. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. Touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh no, 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 I'm a rocket man. Rocket man, burning out his fuse out of every home. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time to touchdown brings me round again. In fact, it's cold as hell, and there's no one there to raise them.
Desert training, where we were out.
If you did,
you would survive for several days before they could pick you up. Trained in jungle training.
And all the science I don't understand. It's just my job 5 days. Rocket.
to John Glenn. I was in the Black House and he was and last to speak to him before liftoff. Gus and Al had both done that, but they weren't riding on this big, big fuel tank that had enough, had the ability to give him more speed than what Al and Gus had had. They didn't have enough to coast all the way around the world. They just had enough to go up a little ways.
It's gonna be a long, long time.
People look at all this fire and smoke on the ground and they think you're under huge stress inside. You're not. The thrust is just barely greater than the weight of the spacecraft, so you lift off very gently. And the more the fuel burns...